Good morning, Heartbeat Andrea. Good morning, Heartbeat Troy and Heartbeat Queen O. Good morning, Heartbeat Sherry. How are you this morning? Hey there, Heartbeat Latanya. Good morning. Good morning to you guys. It is a wonderful day. God is in the blessing business. He woke all of us up this morning. So that right there is enough to give him praise. Hey there, Heartbeat on Gwen. I see you just popped up there. I see you. Good morning to you guys. Hope you are feeling good. Hey there, Heartbeat Rochelle. Good, great morning to you too. Good morning. Good morning. Taking it all back Tuesday. Trouble-free Tuesday. Oh, I love this. Taking it all back and trouble-free Tuesday. I love it. I love it. I love it. Good morning, Heartbeat Belinda. We're taking it all back and it's trouble-free Tuesday. I love that. You guys come up with some good things. What's happening, Heartbeat Troy? Good morning, Heartbeat Juanita. Good morning, good morning, good morning. I love how you guys communicate with each other and telling each other good morning. I love it. It's Heartbeat Nation. God wants me whole nation. That's right. Good morning, Heartbeat Pudding Pop. Good morning, good morning. And so we are going to get started. I am Regina Banks, your GPS to wholeness. Welcome to the Gathering of Hearts this morning. And your daily dosage for today is faith without works is dead. Faith without works is dead. Good morning, Heartbeat Elaine, and good morning, Heartbeat Donald. And so, you know, we've been talking about breakthrough, and we received a prophetic word about breakthrough and change is coming, and we get excited about it. And that's a great thing because we believe the word of God that we hear. But what are you doing with the word once this live stream goes off? What are you doing with it? Are you putting it into action? What are you doing to prepare for the blessings and the breakthrough that has been prophetically spoken over our lives? You know, in the prophetic word last week that God gave, he said, prepare for it. And then he sealed it with this. God himself, you know, he said, I have spoken. And so what are we doing with the prophetic word that we are hearing? So if you're believing for financial breakthrough and you heard a word saying that breakthrough is coming, what are you doing? Are you tithing? Are you sowing seed? Are you giving your offering? Are you, you know, watching what you do? Are you not giving Starbucks as much money? You know, are you, you know, limiting what you do with Chick-fil-A? What are you doing? Going to prepare for breakthrough? Because see, there's one thing to receive a word, and the next thing is, what are you doing with that word? Because faith without works is what? It is dead. So if you're believing for a turnaround in your health, like, what are you doing? Are you changing your eating habits? Are you exercising more? Are you getting more rest? Are you eating less carbs, less salt, less sugar, but more vegetables? You know, changing the oils that you cook in, using something that doesn't have as much saturated fat. What are you doing as you are preparing for the blessing? What are you doing as you're preparing for the breakthrough? So God said he's going to restore us. He's going to renovate us. He's going to reinstate us. He's going to reinvent us. So with that being said, what good is all of that if God is going to give you a fresh start, if God is going to redeem the time for you, but you're not going to change your mindset? You're not going to prepare for breakthrough. So what good is all of that if we aren't putting any action behind the word that we're hearing? And I know the last couple of days we've been like so excited, and we should be, but I wouldn't be the person that I'm called to be if I don't make you look back at yourself and say, okay, the blessing is coming, but what am I doing to change to make sure I don't end up back in the same situation? I think it was last week we talked about that vicious cycle, that if you don't change your mindset, then you're just going to end back up in the same place. This is breakthrough. This is the time where God is, you know, telling us that it is our season. And so this is the time where we have to get it right. We have to drop those bad habits. We have to put action behind our faith, what we're believing God for. And so this is what I need you guys to do. Take a look at yourself. I want to see the heart. hearts and the likes. Come on, give me the hearts and the likes because of this word too. It's still good. What are we doing to prepare for what God is bringing us to so that we don't end up in the same situation? Good morning, Heartbeat Carolyn, and good morning, Heartbeat Tanya. What are we doing to make sure that we're able to receive what God is preparing us up for? So faith without works is dead because what? Faith reveals an unchanged life or a spiritual dead heart. When we have faith without works, it's showing that we're not obeying the word of God. I'm going to repeat that again. Faith without works is dead faith because it reveals an unchanged life or a spiritually dead heart. How we live, how we operate in our lives, it reveals or demonstrates whether the word that we confess is active or not, or whether we're really living by faith. And so it's okay to have the hallelujahs and thank you, Jesus, and the glory to God, but what are you doing? Is there any action? See, our works are the evidence of salvation and obedience. If you're living a life of disobedience, then you're living with dead faith. And I know that might not sound good, but everything that we eat is and doesn't taste good, but it's good for you. And so if you're living a life of disobedience, then you're living a life of dead faith. So remember, Jesus said that your fruit, people will know you by your fruit. So what does your fruit look like? What does your life look like? Does it look like Jesus? Does it look like you're obeying the word of God? So James 2:26 tells us this in the easy reading version. It says, a person's body that does not have a spirit is dead. It is the same with faith. Faith that does nothing is dead. The Passion Translation says it like this: for just as a human body without the spirit is a dead corpse, so faith without the expression of good works is dead. So what are your actions saying about you? And if you read that chapter, it goes through people who showed they had faith, like Abraham when he was getting ready to sacrifice Isaac. You know, he showed that he had faith in what God had said. And so what are your actions saying about you? Are you really ready for breakthrough? Have you made it, or have you at least started making the necessary changes in you to reach this state of wholeness? What are you doing? And so here's a question I want you to really, really think about. If Jesus were to come and sit down right beside you right at this moment and ask you, what are you doing with the word that you are hearing? What would be your response? What would be your response? Think about it. And remember that faith without works is dead. And so you've got to activate your faith. Every word that you're hearing on these mornings that we're getting up together, and thank you guys so much for getting up with me. Every morning that we're getting up together, we're receiving a powerful word from God. But what are we doing with it? When the live stream is over, what are you doing with it? After you've said your hallelujahs and praise you, Jesus, and that was a good word, what are you doing with that word? Are you applying it to your life? And so again, I want you to think about that question that I asked. If Jesus were to come, sit right down beside you right now, and if he said, Heartbeat Juanita, Heartbeat Latanya, Heartbeat Troy, Heartbeat Belinda, Heartbeat Rachel, what are you doing with the word that you are hearing every day? How are you applying it to your life? What would your answer be? Hey, that's your daily dosage for today. I want you guys to think about this, that faith without works is dead. And in order to receive the prophetic word that we have been hearing, in order to walk in breakthrough, in order to walk into wholeness, in order to get our prayers answered, we've got to do something. We've got to activate our faith. And so if you have not been activating your faith, if you have not been applying the word of God, no worries. It's never too late to start applying the word of God to your life. And so this morning, when you get off this live stream, I want you to think about what have you been doing with the word that you've been hearing? Because the word makes us prosperous. When we stay in the word, Joshua tells us to meditate. I say meditate on it day and night, that you might make your own way prosperous, that you might see good success. So what are you doing with the faith that you are hearing? What are you doing with the word? Are you activating your faith? Remember, I talked about mixing the word with faith so that you can have a great outcome. And so that is what I want you to think about today as you're out and about in your day. How am I taking this word and applying it to my life? How am I taking action? How am I showing faith? Remember, Peter asked God, Jesus, he said, if it's you, bid me to come. And what happens? He walked out on his faith because Jesus said, it's me. Come on. And so I'm saying the same thing to you. What are you doing to activate your faith? What are you doing with the word that God has spoken to you? If he's giving you a prophetic word that it's time for you to step out and start the business, why haven't you stepped out? If he's told you that you're healed and you need to make the necessary changes, why haven't you made the necessary changes? God has something amazing for us to do, but we have got to do our part. He wants to bless us. Remember last week he said, ask me for it. He wants to bless you. He wants your life to change, but you have got to do something. And the way you show that you believe the word of God, you activate your faith. You act on it. So this morning, as I leave you, I want you to activate your faith this morning. Do something that you have not done. Do what God has instructed you to do. This time, be obedient. Do what God is asking you to do. Hey, if you guys need me to pray for you, I see that Heartbeat Choi said he's praying for all the heartbeats today. And I pray for you guys daily. But if there is something that you need me to pray for specifically, I need you to just email me at godwantsmewhole.org. Amen. Regina at godwantsmewhole.org. Or you can DM me through Facebook. But if you want to send an email, Regina, R-E-G-I-N-A, at godwantsmewhole.org. Amen. I love you guys a bunch. Hey, don't forget to subscribe to the YouTube channel if you have not already. Make sure you follow us on all the social media platforms. Check out the website, godwantsmewhole.org. Know that I love you most much and that I will see you guys back here tomorrow morning, 7:30 a.m. Have a great day and activate your faith. Hi there, Heartbeat Winona. Welcome to the Gathering of Hearts. Welcome to God Wants Me Whole. Hey, everybody. Welcome, Winona. You are so welcome, Heartbeat Rachel. So welcome. I love you back, Heartbeat Alicia. I love you back. Okay, I'm gone this time, you guys. I love you a bunch.